Wir leben in einem Land, das ein Rechtsstaat ist und in dem Religionsfreiheit gilt.
We live in a country that is a constitutional state where we have freedom of religion and individuals cannot decide to whom this freedom applies and to whom it doesn't.
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar.
In Islamic traditions, the mosque plays a very crucial role. Not only in the daily worship performed by Muslims, but also in the daily practice of governance, civic and humanitarian responsibilities, and spiritual and scholarly research. But over the course of time, and particularly in the current social climate, many people are beginning to doubt the purpose that a mosque serves in their local city or neighborhood. The sight of a minaret appearing on the skyline may raise concern and fear of safety, yet this is not its intention, and therefore the Ahmadiyya Muslim community continues to build mosques around the world based on the true teachings of Islam and its God-given purpose.
This mosque of the Ahmadiyya community is a symbol of peace. I also urge you that irrespective of your faith, creed, race or nationality, you should create in your own areas an atmosphere of peace and help the suffering mankind.
If you think and ponder on the Quranic verses, you will see such verses in the Holy Quran or verses to this effect, that the purpose of mosque in Islam, and one of the purposes of mosque in Islam is to ensure religious freedom. Anybody and everybody should be allowed to come into a mosque peacefully. And if peacefully somebody wants to pray there, then nobody should create any obstacle or nobody should deny him this right.
On the importance of mosques, the promised Messiah, on whom be peace, said, "If you want Islam to progress, build a mosque. Wherever our Jamaat is established, a mosque should be built. Our Jamaat's progress is founded on the construction of mosques. If there are only a few Muslims in a village or a city, build a mosque with good intentions, and God will bring more Muslims to that place." Malfuzat, Volume 2, page 42. Throughout the subsequent years, the community has continued to build mosques around the globe. And with each stride the community takes, a new and bigger mosque emerges from the horizon. Today, London is home to the largest mosque in Western Europe. The Bayt al-Fatah Mosque, with its shining minaret, opened its doors in 2003 and left the world gazing in its glory. Europe's skyline continued to be drawn with the inauguration of two magnificent and awe-inspiring mosques by the fifth spiritual head of the community, Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmad. On the 10th of October, 2008, His Holiness inaugurated the Mubarak Mosque in Saint-Prix, France, which is the first mosque of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community in France.
الحمدللہ اللہ تعالیٰ نے جماعت احمدیہ فرانس کو بھی پہلی مسجد بنانے کی توفیق عطا فرمائی.
It was interesting to see that the individuals who had initially raised objections to the construction of this mosque were present at the inauguration and observed its magnificence in awe and amazement.
اگر ارادہ پختہ ہو اور لگن سچی ہو تو وقت آنے پر خدا تعالیٰ اپنے فضل سے تمام روکیں دور فرما دیتا ہے.
The mayor of Saint-Prix had earlier voiced his concerns while visiting the site when it was only a hall for performing prayers.
So Allah Ta'ala ne inka dil narm kiya aur wahi shakhs jo hame namazon se rokte hue hamare us aazi hal ko girane ke darpay tha hame baqaida masjid ki tamir ke liye na sirf ijazat dene ke liye taiyar ho gaya balki raste ki rokon ko dur karne ke liye khud hamara madadgar ban gaya aur abhi tak ye madad kar rahe hain hamari Allah Ta'ala inko jaza de aur unka seena mazid khole ke wo ahmadiyat ke paigham ko islam ke paigham ko bhi samajhne wale bane.
The same mayor was also present at the inauguration of the mosque, offering his congratulations and support to the Ahmadiyya community. He has continued to help the Ahmadiyya community to remove the hurdles it has faced and has promised to assist in the future when needed. Saint-Pri, a small, unknown town in France, attracted the world's media to its neighborhood to cover the inauguration of this historical mosque.
Et dans le Val d'Oise, la première mosquée Ahmadi, lieu de culte pour la communauté musulmane de la région du Punjab en Inde, a été inaugurée aujourd'hui. C'est la seule en France. Les voisins de toute obédience sont d'ailleurs invités ce soir à un repas. Tania Ouattine avec Stéphane Lisnige.
With all the dignitaries, national and international TV channels, radio stations and newspapers present on the momentous day, the inauguration of the Mubarak Mosque was headline news for all the right reasons. After the successful inauguration of the Mubarak Mosque, the world's eyes turned towards Berlin, where the inauguration of the Khadija Mosque was next on the agenda for Hazrat Khalifatul Masih V. The media assembled in the capital of Germany, anticipating the moment when the doors to the mosque would finally open. There had been months of protests and rallies before the opening. This, therefore, was a major event. By the grace of God, the opening of the Khadija Mosque on the 17th of October 2008 marked the fulfillment of a desire of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community, stretching back to the early 1920s, when it was first proposed that an Ahmadiyya Mosque be built in the city of Berlin.
It was in these days when the German Jamaat was trying to build a mosque in Berlin, when the economic situation became worse day by day. There was not only a recession, it was really, fall down of the whole economy.
At that time, Hazrat Khalifatul Masih II called on the ladies of the community to contribute for the building of a mosque. The fervor, passion and devotion with which the ladies of the community responded to this call was exceptional and unique. Donating cash and jewelry, the ladies amassed 8,000 rupees in cash in just the first week. The total amount collected was approximately 72,000 rupees. The advent of the First World War and the economic situation at the time meant that the construction costs grew beyond budget. Hazrat Khalifatul Masih II, may Allah be pleased with him, decided to temporarily suspend the construction operations in Berlin and ordered that the funds be transferred to London. Allah never closes the door before opening another, and it was by His grace that the transferred funds helped construct the Fazl Mosque in London in 1924. The historical significance that the Fazl Mosque has attained today is for all to see.
اور میں سمجھتا ہوں کہ اس وقت کی احمدی خواتین کی قربانی اتنی سچی تھی اور اس کی قبولیت کے لیے دعائیں اس درد کے ساتھ انہوں نے کی ہوں گی کہ ایک مسجد تو انہوں نے اپنی زندگی میں بنا لی
اور دوسری مسجد کی تعمیر میں ہو سکتا ہے آج ان کی نسلیں شامل ہوئی ہوں.
The fervor and zeal that the ladies demonstrated back in 1924 can still be seen today. It is an amazing coincidence that this time, when a mosque was to be built in Berlin, the world is again faced with an economic crisis. However, Allah has willed that this blessing will be bestowed on the community of the promised Messiah, on whom be peace, and the construction of the mosque was completed before the onset of the current economic crisis. However, the building of the Khadija Mosque was not without its own issues. Since plans to build a new mosque were formalized, a number of groups held protests and voiced their opinions, by and large unfairly and wrongly, accusing the community of denying equal rights to women and opposing a lack of religious freedom. But little did they know that God foresaw everything, and it had been willed and decided that a mosque would be built in Berlin. The architectural design of the Khadija Mosque was developed by a young woman from the Ahmadiyya community in Germany. She also managed the construction process of the Khadija Mosque amongst men, a strong indication of the equality of women within the community. The mosque is built on a plot of land just over 1 acre. Permission was given for a 13-meter high minaret. The mosque has two halls, a flat, a guest house, a library, and a conference room, providing the local community with an ideal center for both spiritual and scholarly education. At the inauguration, His Holiness, in his address, reassured the German people of the loyalty of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community and explained the true purposes for erecting the Khadija Mosque.
This mosque we have built has not been made for any jihadi organization or any terrorist activity, but it has been built simply for the worship of Allah.
Die Moschee der Ahmadiyya-Gemeinde und 250 geladene Gäste kommen zur feierlichen Einweihung.
Das Besondere an der neuen Moschee? Die Frauen bekommen den repräsentativen Raum unter der offenen Kuppel, im Gespräch den Mund zu bedecken.
Lebt, muss man eine Moschee bauen. Das ist das Symbol für die Einheit und der Platz, wo man zusammenkommen kann.
Ob man dort mit Schuhen reinkommen kann, das ist ganz einfach gelöst. Normalerweise darf man eine Moschee ja nicht mit Schuhen betreten, aber der Boden ist mit einer dicken Plastikfolie ausgelegt.
Die Lehrer werden zur gleichen Zeit mit einer bunten Kette für Toleranz und Vielfalt durch Heinersdorf ziehen. Es wird noch eine Weile dauern, bis der Streit um die Moschee vorbei ist.
The opening of the mosque attracted headline news. First mosque opens in Germany's ex-communist East. First mosque in East Berlin opens. Protests fail to stop Berlin Mosque. East Germany's first mosque opens amid protests. First mosque opens in East Germany, marred by protests. East Germany's first mosque to open amid protests. From a communist area to a mosque in Germany. Doors open at Eastern Germany's first mosque. First mosque opens in former East Germany. East Germany to get its first mosque. First mosque in former East Berlin opens to protests. Opposition to the mosque is gradually subsiding and will come to an end when the message of peace starts emanating from this holy place.
From this mosque of ours, There will be no other call apart from love for humanity, affection, reconciliation, justice, and peace. And you will observe and realize that what I have said were not mere words, but were indeed acted upon. And time will, God willing, prove it to be so.
Das war eine sehr ausgewogene Veranstaltung, wo auch viele Menschen aus der Pankower Gesellschaft und darüber hinaus vertreten waren.
Sehr schön. Ich fand es sehr feierlich.
Was mir ganz besonders gefallen hat. Ich muss sagen, ich war eigentlich auch beeindruckt von dem Kalifen und von seiner Ansprache und von seinem Gesichtsausdruck, der eigentlich sehr friedlich war, sehr friedvoll war. Und
I have been very much impressed. It's an extraordinary, beautiful piece of work.
Wenn wir zurückdenken vor 2-3 Jahren, diese zugespitzte Debatte hier im Ort. Ich erinnere mich sehr gut an die Grundsteinlegung, wie wir hier wirklich umlagert waren von Heinersdorfern, Bürgern. Da muss man sagen, das ist doch ein unglaublich guter Prozess gewesen.
In Zukunft wünsche ich mir, dass das, was wir eigentlich in Reinickendorf erlebt haben, eine sehr gute Nachbarschaft mit der Gemeinde, dass die hier auch sehr schnell greift, dass die Nachbarschaft funktioniert, dass die Menschen spüren, dass hier friedfertige Menschen sind und das Willkommen, das der Bürgermeister ausgesprochen hat, letztendlich ein Willkommen dann für alle und von allen sein wird.
On Friday, the 7th of November, His Holiness inaugurated the Al-Mahdi Mosque in Bradford, UK. Taking 2 years to complete, it cost approximately £2.5 million, all paid for by the members of the community.
And Bradford is on the screens around the world as a new £2.5 million mosque is opened in the city.
Welcome to tonight's News in Focus with Sunrise Radio.
The Ahmadi Muslim community of Bradford are unveiling the £2.5 million Masjid al-Mahdi in the city today, and it's funded solely from voluntary contributions. Women gave up jewellery, children offered their pocket money to make this noble project a reality. Hadrat Mirza Masroor Ahmed, Khalifa of the worldwide Ahmadiyya Muslim community, opened the mosque today with Friday prayers.
The Masjid al-Mahdi is one of the largest in the north. It has space for 2,000 worshippers. And Saima Mia is there for us. Saima, I'm sure there are great celebrations today.
Ended the Friday prayers at the inauguration of the mosque. The centre is one of the largest purpose-built mosques in the city and can accommodate more than 2,000 worshippers. The mosque features an 8-metre dome and a huge hall where all community groups are welcome. The Ahmadiyya Muslim community hosted a special reception to mark the inauguration, where various dignitaries from the local community were in attendance. On the 8th of November, the industrial city of Sheffield became the center of attention. The local community gathered to witness the inauguration of Baitul Afiyat Mosque. Hadrat Mirza Masroor Ahmad unveiled a commemorative plaque to mark the occasion. That same evening, dignitaries from different walks of life attended a gathering at the mosque and expressed their delight on this new addition to the city.
It is a pleasure to be associated with an organization, with a religion that says love for all, hate for none. And I think if you reflect on that, really that is what we all ought to be doing in the world today. And with the leadership of this association, then there is real hope around the world to bring peoples together in tolerance and respect for one another.
These mosques will not just be regarded as mere architectural structures, but also as centres for interfaith dialogue, promoting peace and harmony.